Hi, welcome. Today I would like to talk about Swift 3 optional types. So let's get started. I have an Xcode a playground open, and I have a sample class animal where it basically has two properties, number of legs and age. Both of them are integers, and I have an initializer, and I'm basically declaring an object of type animal and getting it, and you can see we get the animal, and you can kind of check the details. It says the number of legs is 4, age is 1, and so that's all fine and dandy. So let me try to introduce you to the concept of optional types. So let's say, for example, I want to do object is equal to nil in Swift 3. And as you can see, it is going to give me a problem. And it says here itself that nil cannot be assigned to a type animal. That's because in Swift, if you just declare things without anything specific, it's not going to really be, it has to be assigned to an object. It cannot really be nil. So if you want to declare that this variable object can be nil, what you can do is you can put a question mark in front of it, like an optional type, and then the compiler is not going to complain, and it says object equal to nil is fine. So let me talk to you about a quick concept that how do you dereferences something like this. So now you are able to assign it to an object of nil. A typical way of looking at it is just to say let object is equal to object. And let me just write it down, and then I'll print, tell you what it is. Print object dot age and here I'm going to just say that object is nil. So as you can see, this works fine where it comes here and says object is equal to nil. So a little bit more detail about this statement. What it does is it creates a new really, you can think of it as a local variable. You can really rename it to anything else, but it's kind of a little bit weird to put in a different name here and here. So I just kind of go along with the same name because you don't have to invent a new name. But it says that if this is assigned and it's going to be non-nil, you take the if part and it'll print the age. And you can kind of check this by commenting this line up where object was assigned to nil. So now it's going to take this portion, and you can see the age was 1. So this is how you actually have an optional type. This is a typical way of dereferencing it and checking it whether this is good or not. Let me show you one more thing here just to kind of get this completed. Let's say I just say print object dot number of legs. And if I try to do it like this without, let's say, an optional type in front of it, it is complaining and it's not going to work because this could be nil and it's an optional type. And you can see that this would typically, to make it work, what you want to say is that you know for sure that when you are unwrapping this object or essentially getting its value, you can use an operator called the bang operator in front of it. That means that you are going to get its value, and you know that this is not going to be nil, so it comes back as 4 and it works fine. You would see a problem if I change this to object equal to nil. If object is equal to nil here, you can see that it's going to complain that this is a bad exception because it assumed that you have assured that this object was not nil. Another thing you can do is instead of an optional type, you can also use the bang operator. If you use the bang operator in front of it, it basically means that this object is nil, but typically in your programming, it's not going to be nil. And here you can see it's complaining about an error here. So typical usage would be when it's not nil. So you could have it like this. And here you can access it like this. Let me see if you can even access it without this object, nil operator. So here you can see that you are able to access this up without the optional operator if you declare it with a bang. So essentially, to declare an optional type, you have an option either to declare it with a question mark if you want to be able to have its value to be nil, or you can also do the bang. But then you do the bang, you typically have to make sure that your program is going to safeguard and not in any way assign this to nil. So hopefully this helps you with some understanding of optional types. And the optional types are actually not just related to class objects. It can be to very basic types such as an integer. So let's say if I declare an x to be an integer, okay, let's not worry about this, but basically take my word for it that if you have optional types, you can have the basic objects as optional types as well. So if you want to know more about this and search for other Swift related videos, you can go to my website Gaur Associates and search for Swift 3, and I'll put this video in there also. So thank you for watching this short screencast, and you have a great day.